Okay, so welcome back again. So now we are moving to discuss one of the general topic that is how to collect algae. Now you are very familiar with different types of algae, and the algae belongs to various groups, etc. You studied, but when you are going to a laboratory or practical to study about algae, you have to know how to collect these algae from your surroundings. You know the habitats of algae, where it is growing. Some are growing as terrestrial, some present in soil, some present in the tree trunks, some in sand, and also in free floating, submerged, etc. In various places you can see algae. So before going to study or do practical, you have to first collect this algae. So algae can be collected from these various habitats by adopting different methods. So we are observing this algae under compound microscope or binocular microscope or any way. So in the microscope you can study each and every part of that algae. You can take photographs and thereby you can go into identify the algae. So algal study is a very important part of our subject, and in order to study the algae, you have to collect the algae from its habitats. So how this collection is going on? And today in this class we are going to discuss the collection methods, algae collection methods. Okay, so you know algae may be of different sizes. So they may be of microscopic, macroscopic. Some you can see with your naked eyes, and some algae you cannot see with your naked eyes, that you can observe only under microscope. So there are planktonic forms, there are macroalgae, there are terrestrial growing in soil or tree trunk, then floating, submerged, various types you can see. So collection methods for all these types are entirely different. Okay. So in order to collect planktons, you have to adopt a method. In order to collect macroalgae, you have to adopt another method. For collecting floating, another method. Likewise, for each and every type, you have to follow a particular collection method that depends on the particular habitat of the algae. Clear? So first we are moving on to discuss the collection methods of macroalgae. So what are macroalgae? Macroalgae are the algae that we can visible with our naked eyes. They may be floating, they may be present in the shallow water or anywhere. So, but we can observe its presence in the water. So, it is very simple. You just put a have a gloves and you just take it from the water with your palm. And or you can collect like this, or you can use some forceps or some spoon or likewise, and you can take it out. Okay, and forceps are mainly used for collecting algae because it is very simple and it will come attach onto the forceps. Okay, and some other methods are there, that is known as grapnel and dredge, two equipments used to collect algae, grapnel and dredge. These are usually adopted for collecting algae in large scale from ocean, usually the marine algae by scientists. They are they have a special type of ship or vessel. That vessel contain all the type of system for storage, system for identification, everything in that vessel for algal study. And that is in such cases they are using grapnel or dredge. This is the grapnel and this is the dredge, two equipments by which they can easily collect the algae from the ocean. Okay, so macroalgae can be collected easily with our naked hands, but you should usually wear gloves. That is better for collecting algae because the water may be polluted. Understood? Okay, now then this grapnel and one is the dredge. Okay, I have to remember the two names. Now thick mats of algae like Eudogonium, Spirogyra, Sygnema, they form a hard green mat in the water. It is easy to take by hand. Okay, they are free floating type also. So larger masses, so see here, a large mass of algae is collected from the water. So if you are obtaining like this, you have to first squeeze it. What is squeeze it? Press it and remove all the excess water, then store in polythene bags and get back to your laboratory. Clear? So this is a very simple method of collecting algae by that is by macro algae. Okay, now from the natural sources, like natural surfaces. So algae are growing on the pebbles, stones, then hard that baby jellies, stones, so marbles, etc. So from this, it's a surface usually having algae. So you can collect it by using the devices like spatula, teaspoons, toothbrushes, etc. And scrap it, means churandu. Scrap it from the surfaces and collect it and carefully transfer to the container. Okay, you can use a plastic container, you can use petri plate or anything. So scrap it from the surface and transfer into the container. Okay, usually a knife is used for scrapping. You can scrap it by using knife also. Okay, and after settlement, so put in the container, add water, then water is removed, algae will settle down and you can transport it into your laboratory. Clear? So this is the algae attached from certain surfaces. Now, from sediments. Sediments are usually accumulated at the bottom of the water. So such a sediments, you can have a large number of algae, usually green algae, diatoms, etc. So blue-green algae is also present. So from sediments, how will you collect the samples or algae? So you can collect it by using glass tubes or plastic pipes. So that can be injected into the sediment surface, plastic pipes or glass tubes. The tube is filled with water and just suck it out, the algal specimens will transfer into the container. Okay. Then that is kept undisturbed for the dark for several hours. Then the solid particle will settle down and the supernatant that contains algae will be removed out. Okay. So it is by using a pipe or by using a glass tube that press into the sediments, then it will be that algae containing water will be coming out, then allow them to sediment, the solid particles will sediment, algae will float. This is the simple method. So these are the pipe containing dredge, the method pipe is used. Usually in the marine systems, deep oceans, deep river, etc. This method is used. Okay. So these are the equipments thereby they carry for collecting this algae. Okay. Now from sand. Sand is another important source of algae. You know, seashore area is very important that containing huge number of algae. Then algae attached to the sand grains are common. Okay. So sample should be collected depth from 5 cm. So 5 cm depth in the seashore area or sand area you can collect the samples. Sand grains are removed out by adding little water, agitated, speedily stirring or agitating, and that sand grains will remove and algae can be taken out. That is from sand. See, this is the method. Sand is first taken out, then pour into the bucket or somewhere. Then it's continuous agitation, solids will set, algae will float. Then this is a floating algae. So usually we need this method of collection. So in our research purposes, we have to study the planktons, planktonic algae. Planktons, you know, about mainly include diatoms. So how will you collect them? It's very difficult to collect while sinking into the water. So usually when you're traveling in the boat or ship, etc., you can use an item like this. This is the plankton net. So plankton net is made up of bolting silk, if very minute mesh size, means its holes are very minute. So and at its end you can see a vessel that is steel container, and this is kept down into the water. Water along with the planktons enter through it. Then you can see with it, and only that algae containing water will be coming down. This is the method. Okay. So this is very important. Then careful washing of the net is very important. Otherwise, it will not carry algae in the next time. So washing is very important because sediments will accumulate inside this. Okay. Plankton net for carrying floating algae. Then use of bucket or jug, best result to obtain plankton sample from moving or static water. So you can use bucket. This is a plankton net. Transfer it into a bucket and filtered many times by centrifuge. Centrifuge is a rotatory system, and you can take this sample from this plankton net, then add water, centrifuge it, algae will settle down at the bottom. Okay. Algae fall into the bottom of the container. This is the plankton net. This is the water. that we filtered and finally we obtained only algae. Clear? And terrestrial form is the next one. So terrestrial means usually they attached on the tree barks. Usually you can see on the bark of the tree. How will you taken it? So you can collect it by scraping from the bark surface and transfer into wide mouthed bottle. Okay. Then soil algae also present as crust mat. Soil algae is also terrestrial form. That also can be taken out by spatula or by this method and dissolve it. Okay. You can collect by using a knife, blade or spatula or spoon. Now, so now we studied the how to collect algae, planktons, free floating, then marine forms, sediments, sands, planktons, etc. You studied how to collect. The next step is, so today you collected, tomorrow you will collect, and many days back you collected. So the different collections will be there in your hand from different localities, from different area. Once you collected in from Kollam, next collection is from Trivandrum, next collection is from Kannur, etc. So, while coming into the laboratory, you have to do some arrangements for that, for easy identification. So, in that collection bottle, you can write collector's name, that is your name. Then, number, put a number also, that's a code number of that sample. Then, put a tag inserted inside the solution or put outside by pasting it on the bottle. And the tag should contain all the details from where you collected and also the collection site, habitat, is it a stream, is it a river or lake or terrestrial form, what is the color when you taking it out, what is the color, texture, size, etc. Because this information you will get only while you are at the time of collection. Later, you are usually preserving this algae in some chemicals. So, it will not retain its original color, texture, etc. So, it is very important for us to note the information from the collection time itself. So, that everything you should write in the bottle and also in your diary for easy identification. Clear? So, this is the chart, sample name, then collected date, time, then from where collected, then everything, is it from bark or from trees? Or soil or from where you put a tick mark, likewise the total number of collections, how many collections from that site. Likewise, you can prepare a chart and keep it as your own. This is a collection information. So, this is all about the algae collection. So, in this class, we studied algae are collected mainly for identifying, and collected algae should kept into the laboratory, and how you can collect the algae growing in different habitats. So, you can study it very well and prepare its notes also. So, have a nice day. Thank you.